OpenAI Sora is here. It looks so real that it just threatens every videographer on the planet. And now I'm going to make it even better, using AI to turn it into 3D and spatial video on Apple Vision Pro right here. Remember, Apple said that spatial video is for capturing your memories for the future? Well, now you don't even know if your spatial memories are yours or AI generated. Scary thought. But I'm still going to teach you how to do that in this tutorial, so you have that power as well. At least I am leveling the playing field. Even better, I'm also going to teach you how to generate volume from this 3D AI video so you can put it on a device like the looking glass right here in Hologram. Let's learn this AI thing together. I will keep this tutorial short. AI just makes things so much easier now. There is not much to teach. OpenAI Sora is just a text-to-video or video-to-video AI engine. Very much like Stable Diffusion, but 100 times better now with spatial consistency. People think you can only do text to video, but the true power, for a videographer at least, is to drive the AI generation with your own video as a guide. You can see the example in Sora official research paper right here. In this video, we focus on step 2, how to turn any 2D video, including the AI generated one, into 3D and spatial video on Apple Vision Pro. The easiest method is using an online services like the HaloDepth by Spatial Gen. So you don't need to own expensive hardware like a PC with RTX 4090 GPU or understand the technical know-how of spatial video conversion. Go to HaloDepth, link in description down below. Click the convert video button right here. Now just drop in your video, hit next, pay and convert. When it's done, you will get a side-by-side 3D video and a spatial video. The spatial video is ready to play inside your Vision Pro. No extra work is needed. HaloDepth is not free. It costs $1.50 per minute for 1080p 30 frames per second video and $120 per minute for 4K video. It's relatively cheap if you are just a casual user. OpenAI Sora generates less than 1080p video anyway, so it is fine. But if you want 4K, that will cost you and it adds up. Now, let me teach you the hard way and the free way. It requires you to have a PC like my Gigabit Aurora 17X right here with NVIDIA RTX 4090 GPU. You will also need a software called R3D. It's completely free if you just need to convert 1 minute 2D video. It is about $139 one-time purchase for a lifetime license if your videos are more than a minute long. If you are very cheap, you can chop your video into several 1 minute pieces, then you can use it for free forever. But don't be that guy, support the developer by paying the software. This workflow works for any 2D video, not just AI generated one. But it does not work for 260 or VR 180 video yet. Sorry guys, the VR conversion tutorial is coming next though. Open R3D on your PC, drop in your video, there is a video generated by OpenAI Sora. Under 3D formats, choose side-by-side, SVS, meaning side-by-side for VR, and RGB depth, which is for holographic display like the looking glass right here. We want both format and I will demo the looking glass workflow in the end. It's very cool if you can turn your AI art into a real physical art like this one. Very rewarding. Open advanced settings under video encoding setting, choose quality optimize. You can adjust the video 3D effects here if you see 3D artifacts like this one. This is a more case by case situation. If you have a detailed background like this one, reducing the 3D strength will always give you a better result, but with less 3D. Make sure you enable GPU encoding. If not, it is gonna be very slow. Make sure you enable enhanced detail. If you download some AI model, just like Topaz Video AI you're familiar with, to further improve the details. Go ahead and hit start and it will run. Next, bring the 3D side-by-side video back into your Mac, open Terminal, and use FFMPEG Spatial plugin to make an Apple Spatial video from this 3D video. Again, the detailed tutorial is right here. Watch it if you need more help. Sometimes, the Owl3D render video does not work on Mac. If this is the case, use the free Handbrake Mac software to transcode it into H.264. See the Handbrake download link in the description. I provided an automation code in the download document down below as well. This is an improved code from Mike Swanson's original code. If your folder structure is like this, with all the MP4 files and the spatial FFMPEG code file inside, you can copy and paste this in-handed code right here. If you go through your entire folder, batch processing all the MP4 files into MVHEVC spatial video, you can walk away, get a cup of coffee, come back, and all the videos are ready to be airdropped onto your Apple Vision Pro right here. Wow, it looks amazing. AI generated spatial memory look as good as real capture memory. Well, don't leave yet. Let's make this a step further by loading this 3D spatial video onto your looking glass. Plug in your looking glass portrait or the Go, which I don't really have right now. Open up Looking Glass Studio, drop in the RGB depth render, and adjust the focus to make sure your subject is in perfect focus, just like in 3D. Now, sync your looking glass, you can unplug it now and put it anywhere, and it will showcase as a holographic video as you see right here. Completely from your imagination. How cool is that? Hey, don't forget to subscribe if you are new here and ring the notification bell for more tutorials just like this one. Drop Kimchi a like and a thank you comment down below. If you need more help on converting AI video into spatial video on Apple Vision Pro, check out this tutorial right here. If you are traveling with your Vision Pro, watch this one before you get on a plane. If you need it, I will see you in the next one.